IPL 2020 has been suspended until further notice, the BCCI announced on Thursday, meaning it's been suspended but not cancelled. So unlike the Wimbledon or some of the Formula One races, there is still hope of an IPL happening later in the year. But to find an open window for this IPL later in the year, it's going to be a game of who blinks first for the BCCI and a lot of the other cricket boards involved. That and how a cancelled IPL would affect some of the players, some of the stakeholders in the league, not so much the BCCI, is what we're going to be talking about in this week's Spotlight. If not now, then when? The IPL has the luxury of blocking out 2 months in the summer, with foreign cricket boards sort of accommodating that and planning bilateral series around the 2 months of the IPL. But now, moving the IPL to later in the summer will mean sort of poaching onto the time slot that has been designated for some other bilateral series. May, June and July sort of look unlikely considering the reach of this pandemic and what all the governments across the world are doing to restrict the spread of the coronavirus. August has an open window in the Indian cricket calendar, but there's England playing Pakistan and South Africa playing West Indies, and getting those series cancelled looks highly unlikely. Now, September has the Asia Cup, and this one's very interesting because the Asia Cup is set to be hosted by Pakistan this time round, but India had already refused to travel to Pakistan for the tournament, so a date and a venue for the tournament were to be discussed in March when the pandemic struck and all those meetings were cancelled. So we don't yet have a date for the Asia Cup, although Pakistan Cricket Board's chairman Ehsan Mani has already said it looks unlikely that they will be cancelling the Asia Cup to make way for the IPL. Now, the other big window is the last week of October stretching on to November, which is scheduled for the T20 World Cup. Now, Australia are the hosts this time round, and Cricket Australia has said that they are keen on hosting the tournament, but Australia's government has sealed the borders for 6 months in March, so it remains to be seen if they do open the borders in time for the World Cup to take place, and if the government even gives allowance for so many countries and so many teams from so many countries to travel to the nation for the World Cup. And if the World Cup, of course, is cancelled or rescheduled, that four-week window, along with a couple of weeks here and there, is what the BCCI could be looking at to hold the IPL this time round. Some of the other ideas being thrown around are, of course, of a shorter IPL. Instead of 8 weeks, it's probably going to be 3 or 4 weeks this time round if an IPL does happen. There's also the idea of an Indian-only IPL taking place. It is, of course, after all, the Indian Premier League, but team owners have repeatedly stated that they will want an IPL that does involve a lot of foreign players. So, you know, that's a balance that the BCCI need to take care of when they do make a decision on rescheduling the tournament this time around. Now, another interesting option being thrown into the mix is of hosting the IPL outside of India. And the Sri Lankan Cricket Board, yesterday after the IPL was postponed, has already volunteered to host the league on their shores. Sri Lanka, of course, are also dealing with the coronavirus pandemic, but the nation has only seen just over 200 cases so far. They are a lot more stringent in their lockdown than India is. So it remains to be seen if they do get government clearances to invite so many players from outside their nation to host to play the tournament. But their cricket board chief Shami Silva had told ESPN Cricinfo, if the Indian board does agree to play the tournament here, we're ready to provide facilities in line with the requirements and recommendations of medical professionals. It would be a substantial source of income for Sri Lankan cricket as well. And of course, the money that the IPL generates is also the reason the stakeholders haven't really, decided to cancel the IPL just yet and are still clutching at straws to postpone the IPL and host some sort of the tournament later in the year. You know, because of the coronavirus pandemic, a lot of nations, not just cricket boards, are dealing with severe economic repercussions. But cricket boards as well, Cricket Australia has already laid off a lot of their staff. The England Cricket Board, the English players have taken pay cuts. The Australian players are already saying that, they're prepared for a pay cut in their salaries. But any sort of money that the IPL generates will come as a huge relief for a lot of the stakeholders. Somebody like a Pat Cummins, he was, he became the highest selling overseas player in an IPL auction in December. 15.50 crore he was picked up for by the Kolkata Knight Riders. Now he doesn't get any of that money unless an IPL happens. The salary structure of players is such that they get a little bit of it 1 week before the league starts, and the rest of the payment comes as the league progresses. So unless there is a league, players don't get paid. And let's see if we do get an IPL this year, and who all in fact do end up taking part in the league.